Amy Meineke, and I am a Lutheran pastor serving an Episcopal congregation on the north side. I am also on the board of the Fig Tree. Folks from my congregation are here. So I am here to welcome and invite Mark Kinney to begin our, we've heard some speakers, we're going to hear some more. So Mark, who is from Thriving Financial for Christians, is that now the official title?
We're working on it.
We're working on it. And a new writer and all kinds of things. So Mark.
Thank you for being with us today as we gather to celebrate the very important work of the Fig Tree and the tremendous impact it makes in our community by sharing inspirational stories of faith and action by individuals and organizations. So I want to tell you how I came to be standing before you today. And it's largely through the efforts of one person, Madeline Mathis. Is Madeline here?
Yeah.
Where are you at? There she is. Any Madeline fans here? I had just become executive director of Mission Community Outreach Center back in 2011, and although I had been on the board of directors for several years, I had no clue what I was doing. I knew how to unlock the door and answer the phone. And that's where Madeline came in as my mentor. At the time, she was executive director of Family Promise, and I don't know why, but she took an interest in me. We cooperated, our two nonprofits cooperated. So every couple of days, my phone would ring, and it would be Madeline. And she would have something for me to do. She would present an opportunity, connect me with somebody who could help me, but just be my mentor. Little things like, if an opportunity came along for Family Promise that they couldn't take advantage of, she gave it to me. That's how we got brand new pajamas for kids, hundreds of them, through Madeline. Blankets for people who didn't have blankets, through Madeline. So Madeline, I want to thank you for everything you did for me. From the bottom of my heart, you became my mentor. Thank you. So what Madeline did, repeatedly, she told me, Mark, you got to meet Mary Stanton. She must have told me that 10 times. She said, you got to meet Mary Stanton, and you got to have her do a story on you and on Mission Community Outreach Center. So I called Mary, and she said, okay. And she came over and she did a story on me back in 2012, winter of 2012. And I got to tell you, for who's heard of Mission Community Outreach Center? Okay, you guys are clued in because you read the picture. But our profile was raised significantly by that story Mary did on me. And it was just a story of my faith journey and what brought me to be executive director of Mission Community Outreach Center. So Mary, thank you very much for all you did for Mission Community Outreach Center. So, I'll go ahead on my story. So speaking as a former nonprofit director, I highly endorse the Fig Tree for a couple of reasons. Because of the stories it tells in the newspaper, but also because of the resource directory, which I think we all have used at one time or another. But I know it helped us connect people with the resources they needed. Mission Community Outreach Center serves the lowest of the low-income people in Spokane. We serve them with basic needs like clothing and household goods, but that was just the beginning of the story for most of them. And by use of the resource directory, we're able to connect them with their further needs. So it's so important. So I also write for the Fig Tree. I have written two stories so far. I wrote a story on my friend Charles Brondos, who has taken an interest in an organization called Feed My Starving Children. Are you familiar with that? Okay, Feed My Starving Children helps feed children in hunger situations worldwide, and we're on our third year now. We're doing a mobile pack at Redeemer Lutheran Church on September 28th and 29th. So I invite you all to come out and see that. So when I approached Mary with the story idea to write a story on Charles, she said okay. And then I said, also, I would prefer not to be edited. And she just made the face that she made. So I wrote the story, and it was very well edited, so thank you. and Shaw, who are working as volunteer ombudsmen in North Idaho in a long-term care facility. So those are the stories that you can share in the Fig Tree. People's faith in action and what brought them to do the work they're doing. I'm currently writing a story on my friend Ken Fay, who works with Comfort Dogs through Lutheran Church Charities. They go to tragedies, they've been to different school shootings. They started off, his work started off in Newtown, Connecticut, where he was a church member. So Mary, when is the deadline for the April issue?
Next Friday.
Next Friday? You'll have it. Okay. So who knows, the Fig Tree is beginning its 35th year of May. Is that incredible? Just think, what were you doing 35 years ago? I was a freshman in college, if you can believe that. So. But why do I support the Fig Tree as an advertiser and a sponsor? Very simply, because I value the work that it does in this community. It allows me to connect with wonderful people of faith, just like all of you. So I hope you will join me in generously supporting it so that it can continue its very important work for many years to come.